عسى مثلا فيك تحددي لنا من أي صفحة لأي صفحة فينا ناخد معلومات هيك عن المقرر؟
Okay, so I'm asking you about if you have any questions concerning the test. The test or comprehension test will be similar to the last semester, okay? And it is similar to the style of questions in the book, okay? You see that for example, study every unit, then we have questions like, for example, reading comprehension, like choose the best answer or answer the following questions. For example, we have some, for example, idiomatic expressions, and we assure that they are important in every unit. You remember that? And we have, like, for example, some question concerning the grammar, some questions concerning, for example, vocabulary or the correct form of a word. These, these exercises, which are found in the book, so we will have a test similar to this style of questions. Okay? Did you understand?
In the book or out the book?
Okay, just I'm talking about the style of questions. The style of
Okay.
questions is similar to the style of questions in the book that are followed every unit. Okay, so they are similar, but
Okay.
the text will be out of the book. Okay, as we had in the previous semester, in the last one, you know that we are, for example, having some text just in order to practice, okay, just in order to, for example, to comprehend, to understand, to try to analyze, نحلل the text, okay, try to be able to answer the questions that are related to the text, okay. This is the point of having some text just for practice, but the test or for example the test the paragraph that you will have it in comprehension test will be out of the book. Is it clear?
Yes, it's clear.
Yes. What about listening and answer?
Let me check it out. I think it's not. There is no question for listening. Okay, just questions concerning the comprehension or understanding, question concerning the idiomatic and the. Oh, okay, there's something important here I want to share with you. Just the idiomatic expressions found in the book, they are requested for you. Okay, you are asked to study the idiomatic expressions that you had it in every unit. Okay, for example, I'll give you an example. In our last unit, which is how did those get in there? We have idiomatic expression in page number 25, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
They are required. مطلوبين. Okay. I'm not talking about just this idiomatic expression. No, I'm talking about this is an example. And we have, for example, another idiomatic expression in the same unit, which is in page 28. Okay. We have two types of question. Question A, which is vocabulary and idiom review. Okay. Every idiom that we studied, okay, it is required. We have question B, which is choose the correct form of the word to fill in the blank. This type of question is also required. Okay? So every idiomatic expression, every correct form of a verb, of a word, sorry, okay, in every unit we studied, they are required. Clear?
Yes.
Okay, I will repeat it just to make sure that you understood it. Every idiomatic expression, for example, I gave you an example of the last unit, which is, for example, in page 25, we have idiomatic expression, which is we have some idiomatic expressions, and below we have some questions like to fill in the blank, one of the above idiom. Okay, so this type of question in every unit is required, and you will see the last page of every unit is also required, because the last page of every unit like consists of two types of questions. The first one, which is idiom, the second one, which is the correct form of the word. Okay, so please focus on the idiomatic expressions in every unit and focus on the last page of every unit. You got it?
Yes.
Okay, yes. Great. Okay, so let me take the attendance before we get started. Well, so this is lecture number 8. Okay, so we have Rama.
Yes.
Suraya. Suraya, are you here? Suraya, can you hear us?
No.
Yes, miss.
Yes, great. Lubna?
Yes.
Okay, Ahmed Ra'i?
Yes, I'm here.
Okay, Ala Rashid? Ala, not here. أسماء بلال، محمود يسوف، محمود، أوكي، وائل حاج ياسين،
Yes, I'm here.
واصل. واصل I think not here. Okay. رؤى.
Yes, I'm here.
مرام. مرام العبد الله.
Yes.
خالد. خالد not here.
Yes.
خالد here.
Here, Anna. Yes.
تهاني.
Yes.
And Haytham.
Yes.
Okay, great. Did I miss any name? Okay. So,
Carol answer. Miss.
Asawa? I didn't
Yes,
mention
miss.
didn't mention your name, Asawer. I'm sorry. I think you're not attending, right?
Asawer. No.
You are not attending. You don't have any attendance like in the previous lectures, right? This is the first time you attend? Asawer. Asawer, can you hear me? She left. I don't know why. Is Asawer attending, or this is the first time? Because she doesn't have any attendance in my sheet. Okay. So I sent you a recording last time. Did you hear it and do the exercise or not?
Yes.
Great. Okay, let me share the screen. Can you see my screen?
Yes.
Okay, great. I think we stopped this part, which is idiomatic expression, and we did it last time, right?
Right.
Yes.
So we will start with page 26, yes. Okay, we have in this page, we have like summary question. So we need to fill in the blank, to fill in the blanks with the correct words or phrases. We need to do this exercise in order like to summarize everything we had in the last lecture. You remember we're talking about, for example, our feeling when we get nervous in, for example, embarrassing situations, right? So we need to fill in the blanks, these words in the books, in order like to make summary. Yes, please, who can read sentence number one and do or give us the correct word? Yes, Lubna, you're raising hand. Go ahead.
When a person is under some stress, his or her body may respond to the stress by making too much cortisol.
Okay, so the answer is respond, right?
Yeah.
Excellent. Very good. Yes. Yes, Rama, sentence number two.
Yes, this chemical benefits the body in many ways in a normal situation.
Yes, very good. So when cortisol is in its normal like level, so it benefits the body, right?
Yes.
Okay, so the answer is normal. Very good. Yes, Ahmed, go ahead with number three.
However, if the body produces a lot of extra cortisol,
Excellent. So the answer is produces.
produces.
Excellent. Yes, number four. Yes, number four. Yes, where are the rest? Yes, Rama.
The cortisol may shut down the person's stomach.
The person's stomach. Excellent. What the meaning of shutdown?
يتوقف.
Yes, like stop working, right?
Yes.
Excellent. Yes, the last one.
Miss?
Yes, Asawa.
This can make people fly like they have three sometimes stomachs.
Okay, this can make people feel like they have. What's the answer in the blank?
Oh, sorry. I have.
Yes, you need to choose or just pick one of the words here. Yes. Yes, I think we lost Suraya. Yes, who can answer? Yes, Lubna.
Yes.
This can make people feel like they have butterflies in their stomachs.
Stomachs, yes. Stomachs, yes, excellent. So the answer here is butterflies. Like they have butterflies in their stomachs. Excellent. So when they get nervous, they feel that they have butterflies in their stomachs. Excellent. So let's move to listening part. Okay. So you're supposed to listen to the audio that I sent. Yes, Haytham? You need to answer?
Yes.
Yes, go ahead, please.
So number one, what are the speakers talking about? Letter A, a situation that makes them nervous. B, people who have too much stress. C, something that affects the stomach. D, the way cortisol works with other chemicals. I think letter D, the way cortisol works, the other chemicals.
Do you agree with your colleague, Haysam, or not?
No, I think letter C.
Yeah, I think that.
Letter C or D?
Letter C.
So they are talking about something that affects the stomach, right?
Yes, right.
Yes, actually it is letter C. This is the right answer. So if you feel that you didn't understand the audio or record, you can listen to it many times in order to get the right answer. Okay, so it is letter C. Yes, question number two.
Yes.
Yes, Ella, go ahead. You need to answer.
Which effect has he read about feeling very large butterflies reducing the level of cortisol, less blood flowing to the stomach, shutting down different muscles?
No, it is muscles.
Muscle.
Yes.
Feeling very large butterfly.
Yes. B or E? Or A, sorry.
A.
A.
Okay, let's see other opinions. What do you think? Do you agree with your colleagues?
No, letter B, I think.
Letter B?
Yes.
And letter D.
D?
Letter D.
Yes.
D, oh.
So many opinions.
Yeah.
Okay, so who says C? So this is the left one. Some of you said like A, B, and D. What about C? Yes, so which one is the suitable one?
There yes, is a cholesterol.
Cortisol. Cortisol, miss. Say cortisol.
Yes. Oh, so now there's fear. صار هلا عدل. So everyone choose one of the answers. A, B, C, D. And so you think that all of them are correct?
C, C.
C?
Yes, miss, C. Retaining the life of cortisol.
No. Okay, so do you think that we need to repeat the audio together?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. I will try. I don't know if the audio will be clear to you. I will try.
Listening. Another reason.
Can you hear or not?
Yes, we hear.
Yes.
Okay, great. So we will listen to it. To decide which the answer is the suitable.
Listening. Another reason for butterflies. Listen to the dialogue and choose the best answer. I heard that a different chemical than cortisol causes butterflies in the stomach.
What chemical did you hear causes them?
I read somewhere that the same chemical that makes you feel stronger when you're excited causes butterflies.
Is the process related to that other chemical very different from cortisol shutting down the stomach?
Not really. The chemical I heard about causes more blood to go to your muscles instead of to your stomach. It's the reduced amount of blood going to the stomach that makes the stomach shut down.
Well, I guess the result is the same in the end. The butterflies come from something shutting down the stomach.
I think please focus that which effect has he read about, not she.
Because he eats reduced amount of the blood going to the stomach.
Yes, so which one? Which letter?
D. Less blood following. D. Less blood following to the stomach.
Yes, very good. So it's B. Because he said that reduced blood. So it produces less blood, right? Reduce,
yeah.
Right? So the answer is B. Okay, is it okay?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, great. So yes, Ru'a, number three.
Yes. Is my voice is it clear?
Yes, it's clear, yes.
I think it's a problem in mic. Okay. What does the woman say about his explanation? Letter D, the result. Is it the same?
Okay, do you agree with your colleague?
Yes.
Yes.
Agree. So, yes, very good. So the answer is letter D. So number one is C. Number two is B. And number three is D. Okay. Okay, so let's go to the discussion. Or before going to the discussion, because we are running out of the time, and I think we just have 1 minute and it will cut after that. Okay, so let's have writing section. Okay, you need to read these questions and read these answers in the form of a paragraph and write your own short paragraph, okay? So I will see you after the cut or connection cut and give you like extra 10 minutes. Is it enough?
Yes.
Okay, so see you after 10 minutes in order to listen or hear from you, like your own paragraph. After like having or listening to your writing, we will have like discussion grammar and the last page. Okay, so see you after 10 minutes. Hello.
Hello, miss.
Hello, miss.
Okay, so you are ready to read your own paragraphs?
Yes.
Okay. Who's gonna start?
Look,
can I?
This Maha.
Yes, Rama. Yes, go ahead.
Yes. After a year ago, when I had presentation in my work, I felt a butterfly in my stomach. In order to relax, I tried to give the...
Rama, can you please repeat it?
Yes. After years ago, when I had presentation
after
in my
years
work...
years ago? What do you mean by yes. after years ago?
قبل عدة سنوات.
Okay, you can say like many years ago.
هذا التعبير خاطئ يعني.
Yes, I didn't hear
Many years ago, when I had presentation in my work, I felt butterfly in my stomach. In order to relax, I tried to give the presentation to my family before I go. Before I go to work. And during the presentation, I tried to breathe and speak slowly and quietly.
I tried I think to breathe.
أتنفس أتكلم ببطء وهدوء.
Yes, breathe, yes.
Yeah. Slowly and quietly. I think it worked well. In the next presentation, I did it well, and I didn't need very much to do this things.
I didn't need very much
to do these things.
You mean like very much effort or what?
تماما إيه إنه ما احتجت كتير لأفعل هاي الأشياء.
Okay, yes, very good. Thank you, Rama.
You're welcome.
Yes, we have. Yes, Ahmed, and then Lubna.
Last time I got butterflies was last year in my final exams.
Can you please repeat?
Last time I got butterflies was last year in my final exams. To calm myself down, I breathed slowly in and out multiple times. And it worked good enough that I can finish my exam and get out.
You guys finish?
Yes.
And what about the last question? What happened in that situation when after you calm yourself down? What happened?
I was able to finish my exam.
Okay, so you get like nervous, or you got nervous because you're talking about something in the past. You got nervous when you had exam, right?
Yes.
Yes, thank you. But your paragraph is a little bit short. You need like to enlarge it.
Okay.
Okay, thank you, Ahmed. Yes, I think I said Lubna.
Yes.
Yes, go ahead.
When I had an exam, I got butterflies in my stomach. I took a deep breath. I put my ball in front of me, and I focused in my answers.
Lubna, please, your voice is, I don't know, is it breaking? Can you please repeat it?
Yeah. When I had an exam, I got butterflies in my stomach.
Yes.
I a deep prayer. I put my goal in front of me, and I focused in my answers. When I did these steps, I was doing well. In that time,
this step or steps?
Steps.
Okay, so you need to make it these steps, not this.
These steps.
Mm-hmm.
I was doing well. In that time, I remembered the answer and solved the exam.
I remember, just add ED.
I remembered,
add ED.
Yes, I add ED.
Okay, you added already. Yes, thank you. This is good. But Lubna, what was the technique that you did like when you tried to deal with this situation? I didn't get it. What you did in order to deal with the situation?
I took a deep breath.
I took what?
Deep breath.
Ah, deep breath. Yes.
Yes. I put on my goals in front of me.
Like you set your goals.
Yes.
Okay.
And I focused in my answers.
So this technique helped you in like focusing on the goal, your goals. And
yes.
like be relaxed, right?
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
Welcome.
Yes, Ru'a, go ahead.
Yes. The last time I got butterflies was when I took the high school exam. And I was nervous
last
about
time
making...
I got butterflies, yes. What?
Was when I took the high school exam.
Okay, you need to add the last time when I got butterflies in my stomach was.
Mm-hmm.
Just add what when.
Yes. Yes. I said when.
Oh, sorry, I didn't hear it. Yes.
Yes, I will repeat. The last time I got butterflies was when I took the high school exam. And I was nervous about making a good marks. During the exam, I tried to stay calm and answer the question.
Was making a good marks?
About making a good...
Okay.
Yes, I was nervous about making...
You need to replace making by getting? By getting good marks. Get just delete a.
Okay.
Yes.
During the exam, I tried to stay calm and answer the question, but I couldn't shake the feeling of nervousness. After the exam, I went for a walk to calm myself down.
Yes.
I found that getting some fresh air helped me to relax.
Mm-hmm.
So in the next time, I answered very well without nervousness.
Yes, very good. Thank you, Ru'a. Yes, anyone else? Yes, this is your chance in order to practice writing, because you know that there is like relationship between reading and writing. So try to read as much as you can. So I see like the same students every lecture do this exercise. And what about the rest? I think just Lubna, Rama, Ru'a, Ahmed. I don't know if I forget anyone, but those students, the most that participate during the lecture. And I think sometimes I hate them, but I'm talking about the writing part, okay? So because it's related to reading, so try to practice, try to... because we're talking about like general topics, you know, so you need to write, you need, and before writing, we already did reading, right? So it is related to each other, reading and writing. So after reading, we need to implement like or to do writing. This is beneficial for you. This is helpful. This is important. Okay. Okay, so no problem. I will get back to the unit. Just tell me if you can see my screen.
Yes, it's clear.
Yes,
okay. Yes, great. So we have here a discussion, and this is the way for practicing speaking, okay? For you to practice speaking. So you need to speak and ignore, forget about your like mistakes, your hesitation. Don't be hesitant. That's kind of tradition. Don't be shy. So just try to talk like at least like one or two sentences to each question. And don't like think about your mistakes, because if you keep like talking or focusing on your mistakes, you will be shy all the time. But when you, for example, practice speaking and you forget about your mistakes, so one time by time, it will be better for you, okay? Your mistakes will be reduced. Your mistakes will be like less than usual. Okay? So when was the last time you were nervous or worried? How did your body react to this feeling? I think we talked about something similar in the last last lecture, but let me see your answers. Can you please answer this question?
Yes.
Yes, Haytham, go ahead.
Yes, when was the last time you were nervous or worried? How did your body react to this feeling?
React. How
yes.
did your body react to this feeling? Yes.
Yeah, yes.
React
the last
to this
time...
feeling, it is like يتفاعل مع هذا الشعور.
Nice. The last time was a week ago, and I had a headache because of it.
Yes, and what was the situation? For example, were you talking about or in front of people, or were you having like terrible situation?
That was when with my children in my home.
Oh, okay. So you get nervous.
Yes.
And what did you do to reduce this nervousness or this stress?
And through I took acetamol pill.
What?
I took acetamol pill.
Oh, so
yes.
you took like headache pills, right?
Yes.
Okay. Yes, very good.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Aysam. Yes, who else can answer question number one and two? Because it's related to each other. When was the last time you get nervous? And what did you do to reduce the stress? Yes, Rama, go ahead.
Yes, I think when I have interview, I feel so worried and nervous, and my head heartbeat it was very fast and quickly, and to reduce this feeling, I try to don't care about what the result it will be.
Yeah.
So that help me to reduce the stress.
Okay, so you try to ignore the situation or the
yes.
result that will be.
Yes. Yes.
Okay.
Because I did everything I can, so I didn't do anything more than.
So just you didn't care.
Yes.
Okay. So as we talked last lecture, there are two possible solutions for this to reduce stress. They mentioned one of them. For example, you can talk about your fears to your friends, to your colleagues, to your, for example, to your beloved ones, for example. Just, yani, you can either talk about your fears in order to reduce them, or as your colleague Rama said, you can just ignore. Okay? Ignore the situation, ignore the result. Okay? And just talk about something different. Try to think about something different from the current situation. Or try, for example, to say jokes. Try to say something funny. Try to make people laugh. Try to laugh. Try to make yourself laugh. Okay? So it depends on the person. Some people prefer to talk about their feelings or their fears in order to reduce them. Some of them try to ignore the situation. And to be honest, I'm with the second type of people. I try to just ignore the situation and just think about something different and not focus on the situation in order not to like get more nervous. Okay, so it depends on the person. Can you agree or not?
Yes, I think that's best as solution
mm-hmm.
to this problem.
Yes, thank you. So let's go to grammar spot. We have here a grammar part, which is causative verbs. We have something called causative verbs in English, and these causative verbs, you know that when we have those like verbs like make, have, help, or get sometimes, we have make, have, help, and sometimes we have get, we need to follow these verbs with an object, and after the object, we need to have like root verb. When we say root verb, so it is infinitive verb. We don't need to add anything to the verb. We don't need to add ed, we don't need to add ing, we don't need to add s, for example, okay? So we call it root verb or infinitive, like its base form, يعني شكله الأساسي, okay? So when we say, for example, causative verbs, they are verbs that cause something to happen. Or cause somebody to, for example, to do something. Okay, that's why they called causative verbs. Okay, let's read the grammar. Causative verbs like make, have, or help, and sometimes we have get. Okay, but you need to memorize these verbs are followed by an object, مفعول به, and a root verb, وفعل بالمصدر. This is an important. Like grammar, okay? Okay, let's have examples here. Cortisol speeds up the way the stomach works, which makes this focus. We have here causative verbs. Okay, so after the causative verb here, we have what? Object, object, okay? مفعول به. So which makes these people feel or to feel sick. What do you think?
To feel sick.
Feel.
Okay, let's get back to the rule. We said here that we have after make, have, help, those causative verbs, we have object and root verb. Did
yes,
we mention we need to add two?
Just a root verb.
Without two. Without two. We didn't mention that we need two after the object, right? So we need just to like to choose the root verb. Okay, so is it feel or to feel?
Feel.
Okay, so it is feel. Okay, which makes this is causative verb, and this is object, and this is the root verb. So the answer is feel. Okay, so we don't need here to add ed or s or ing, just to choose the root verb. Yes, we have example number two. Stepping out onto the stage will also help those butterflies fly or flying?
Fly.
Fly.
Fly, yes, fly. Fly, fly, Ella, not flying, because we need to choose root verb, which is infinitive form of the verb. يعني فعل بالشكل الأساسي. Okay? Okay. Do you have any question concerning this this grammar, because we are running out of the time. Just remember that we have causative verbs like make, have, help. I will give you like example about have because we didn't mention in the example. For example, I can say, for example, she had, for example, she had her brother fix her phone. Okay, she had her brother fix her phone. So we need here to, after had, to get an object, and after it we need to like to choose root verb without to, without s, without ed, without ing, without any ad. Okay, is it clear?
Yes.
Oh, okay, great. And if you want like to learn more about this this grammar, causative verbs, you can just go to Google and write causative verbs. You can see a lot of examples in order to like to have more practice. Okay, just to in order to save our time. Yes, choose the best word or phrase to fill in the blank. Remember that each last page of every unit is important. Okay, yes, just please try to make it fast as much as we can. Yes, he had to take some time off from work because all of the, what do you think? Just give me the answer. Yes, Lubna.
Activity.
Because of the
activity.
Take some time off. Take some time off, like ياخد إجازة from work.
Okay. Stress.
Yes, excellent. Because all of the stress was making him sick.
Okay.
So to take some time off, it means like تاخد يوم إجازة or تاخد أيام عطلة أو وقت عطلة. Okay, so the answer is D, stress. Yes, in some cultures, you should not ask, what do you think?
Personal,
okay. Yes. Personal questions such as person's age, yes. So it is personal. I'm just trying to make it fast because the time is running out. Many patients will
benefit.
Excellent. So as a verb, will benefit. سوف يستفاد from the new treatment. من العلاج الجديد. Yes, excellent. Sometimes it takes several months or even a year before new technology really
catches on.
Yes, very good. And you can review this idiom because we had it last time, I think, right?
Yes,
catches on. Yes, the company plans to a new diet, cola, early next year.
Introduce,
excellent. We should try to... To what?
Reduce.
Excellent. Reduce the amount of electricity we use every month. Reduce. Like to make less of something.
Yes.
Your cheeks are red and you're sweating. Are you
nervous?
Are you nervous? Yes, excellent.
Nervous.
You're sweating like أنت تتعرق. Okay. Yes, very good. And we have here the correct form of the word, and it is important in every unit. Don't forget that. The jar says that this skin can help reduce lines around your eyes. What do you think?
Relax.
Relax.
This skin relaxer. Right? What the meaning of skin relaxer? Yes, it's like something that make the skin relaxed, okay? Like relaxer.
Miss relaxer, which part of speech
relaxer.
Yes.
Okay, it is like
Now.
as a subject, and it is a noun. Yes, as part of
Yes.
speech is a noun. Okay.
Relaxation, a noun, also.
Yes, also noun, but it is like the noun of the thing, but this is a subject, relaxer.
Yes.
Okay. You know what meaning, what jar means?
No.
It is like it is like a glass container, like العلبة أو وعاء الدواء.
Okay.
Okay, glass container. So the skin relaxer, okay, can help. It is like name of a medicine, skin relaxer, can help reduce lines, the jaid around your eyes. Next week or weekend, the store will sell all of its furniture at
reduced.
Just to pronounce it as T. Reduced. Yes. When we say reduced, yes, actually it's of course C. When we say reduced prices, like أسعار مخفضة. Reduced prices. It is an adjective. Yes, and last one, the new program has a lot of over the old program. What do you think?
Benefits.
Benefits.
Yeah.
Benefits. Excellent. A, yes. Benefits. الكثير من الفوائد. So as a noun. A lot of benefits over, يعني يتفوق على the old program. Okay. So we've finished for today. Do you have any questions? We still have 2 minutes.
No, thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you all of you for your good participation. And don't forget about the test next week, inshallah. Don't forget to focus on the thing that we talked about in the beginning of this lecture, which is idiomatic expression in every unit. And the correct form of the word in every unit as well. Okay. And as I told you, the text will be out of the book. And we're like having text from our book just in order to practice, just in order to like increase our comprehension, our understanding, to be able to analyze the text, to be able to answer the questions related to the text. Okay. So thank you all of you. Take care and see you inshallah next week.
Thank you, miss.
Thank you. Goodbye.
Goodbye. Good night.
Goodbye.